Welcome to ToodPad. In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make a flat pattern with a carnival theme. As always, we will start with an 800 pixel squared artboard. We're going to need two layers. We make a white rectangle that covers the whole artboard. Center it and block the layer. Now, on the other layer, we're going to choose the color palette. I've chosen this one, and it's quite festive and it has a lot of colors. If you choose very bright colors and not go very well together, you can lower saturation, making them a bit more pastel. To lower saturation, double-click the color and go where it says S. Also, our pastel colors will give our pattern a childish look. Another thing you need to have in mind when you're doing flat style is that you need to choose a darker and lighter tone of the same color. This way, we will be able to shade our drawing. When we have all our colors, we select them and we create a new swatch group. Now that we have everything set, let's start assigning the flat elements that will go in our pattern. Let's start with the flags. Draw a rectangle and add an anchor point centered on one of the sides. Then, with the direct selection tool, move it until you get something like this. To make the flagpole, we will use the pen tool to make a line with curved corners. Send it back, group and duplicate. Now let's make a couple more flags by modifying the original. We will make a triangular one and a rectangular one. Remember to expand everything so you won't have any problems later. Now, let's make the feathers. Start by creating a spindle shape with a pen tool. When we're done with it, make triangles on the edges like here. We select the objects, and in Pathfinder, we click on minus front. With the pen tool, draw a line that goes across the feather from the tip down. We select everything and divide with Pathfinder. Let's make the right side a bit darker, so we will get the typical flat style shade. Repeat the process a couple of times until you get a few feathers. To make the mask, we're going to make a shape that looks something like this. This will be one side of the mask. We make another spindle shape, but a bit smaller and inside. Apply minus front again. Duplicate both figures and flip them vertically. Make the right side a bit darker. And repeat the steps to make more masks with different shapes. Now, we can add more decorations like the feathers we did before, or other basic elements. In some cultures, fireworks are also typical for these dates. We can draw a rocket just using a rectangle, a triangle, and other simple shapes. Then, draw some diagonal lines to decorate. To divide, use Pathfinder. Balloons are also something very typical and easy to do with a pen tool. We just have to draw a half balloon like here. Duplicate and flip bird. Do the same thing with a knot. Make a triangle, duplicate and flip. Remember to make one half a bit darker. Now, you just have to make the rope that ties your balloon. And remember, expand everything. Make the heart following the same method we did with the balloons. To fill in the gaps left by big objects, you can make little elements like stars or dots. When we have everything, spread all the elements along the upper edge. Now you have to duplicate and paste on top. Without deselecting, right-click, transform, move. Type 800 pixels in vertical and 0 pixels on horizontal. Now we have our top and lower edge completed. Repeat the process, but this time place the elements on the right edge. And in move, type 800 pixels horizontal and 0 vertical. You cannot move these elements if you want your pattern to work. Now fill in the rest of the artboard with more elements. You can repeat the elements by changing the color or the size. Bigger elements will pop out a lot more in our design, but smaller elements will help us fill the gaps left by the others. When we are done, group all the elements with the background. Now we make a square that covers the whole artboard. Select everything and make a clipping mask. Make a copy just in case you have to make any correction. Now we apply transparency to one of the copies. Go to Pathfinder and choose Combine. Drag the result to the swatch palette. Delete the elements we've created, and our pattern is ready. Now, you can use it to create your own postcards or invitations. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and see you on the next one. Bye!